And welcome in, everybody. Glad you're with us. Major League Baseball on tap. It's the Seattle Mariners taking on the Tampa Bay Rays. First pitch coming your way next. All right, first pitch coming up. And our pitcher in this game, Jeffrey Springs. And for some reason, he's not quite as effective here in front of his home crowd, Chris.
Yeah, Boog, and the fans are well aware of that. For him, he's got to just not press and go out there and say, hey, I'm just treating this like any start. Home, on the road, it doesn't matter. My job is to focus on that catcher's mitt, attack hitters, and just try to move through a ball game. So if he can find that kind of focus, it doesn't matter where he's pitching because he has good enough stuff to go out there and win a ball game.
And a pitch. Moore checks his swing. Now an appeal to first. No swing. Earl Hendricks with the call. Keeps the at bat going with a foul ball. And a ball and two strikes. Got him looking for the strikeout. He's got to be frustrated with that call.
Now, this pitching staff has been merciless against him in this one. I mean, he struck out six times in this series, and we've seen no adjustment out of him so far.
And here is Cesar Hernandez. First pitch, and that's in for a strike. In there at the knees.
Well, he didn't like those first two pitches. Now in an 0-2 hole. He's going to have to battle. Hope he gets a mistake.
The next offering misses. And it's 1-2.
It's a good take.
And he grounds one to the right side. Tosses to first. Two up, two down.
Batting third, the center fielder, number 44.
Two outs, base is empty. And now it's Julio Rodriguez. That one's in there, 0-1. Bounce to the right side. Ramirez takes it to the bag, and that will end the inning. We head to the bottom of the first. Now it's the Rays' turn. No score. Back here at Tropicana Field, and our starting pitcher here today, Logan Gilbert.
Yeah, he was a tough luck loser last time out, dominating his opponent. Soft contact. They were able to score a couple of runs. But outside of that, everything was sharp. You hope that he gets a better result this time out. Reward the guy for his hard work.
Josh Lowe leading things off and takes a strike. The pitch. That one to first. A flip to the pitcher covering. One up, one down.
Batting second, the right field.
Here's Lane Thomas. In there, and it's 0-1. And that misses off the outside edge.
The guy at the plate could recognize slider out of the hand. Didn't stay in the tunnel very long in terms of depth and perception. He knew right away it was an off-speed pitch.
Popped up left side, and he can't quite get there. It's a foul ball. The 1-2. Out to short. Moore. And the home first moving along quickly today. Two gone.
The designated hitter. Randy. Oh,
Now it's Randy Arozarena, 5-for-14 in the series coming in. And he pumps it a strike.
Out there on the mound, he's setting the tone early with the fastball, 98 miles per hour up on the scoreboard.
That one missed. The 1-1. Good eye right there.
Boog, he never moved because he never had time to. But that kind of velocity, you'd prefer that pitcher work away.
Ground ball, Walker. He'll do it himself, and that is that. Down in order, go the Rays. We played an inning, no score. Back here at the ballpark, second inning set to go. And the batter now, Christian Walker.
Walker.
The pitch. Ball one there. And another ball. Clyde Washington with home plate duties in this one.
A little bit of a low zone boot from Clyde. Nothing crazy, though. Pitchers that work consistently down around the knees and are able to command their off-speed stuff tend to have some pretty good success with him back there behind the plate.
Short hop liner handled it short to first. One out in the second.
That is it. The right fielder, Teoscar.
Here's Teoscar Hernandez. And takes low for ball one. Nowadays, with advanced metrics and increased use of moving the infielders around, defense isn't necessarily about making errors. Are you able to get to the ball? Are you able to position fielders where guys hit the ball, but within the new shift rules?
And an area that goes unnoticed is the coach that's responsible for positioning and then the research person that's providing the information. So what we're seeing in baseball, so many more people behind the scenes that are contributing to the success between the lines.
Makes the catch for the out.
That'll drive you crazy as a hitter if you let it. I mean, he couldn't have hit that ball more on the screws than he did, and yet he's got nothing to show for it. Hang with him. I know the feeling.
Back when you played, it wasn't the empirical data we have now. It was a guy with a ruler and a diamond taking a colored pencil and drawing a line where he thought someone had hit the ball, right?
That or just going off of gut or feel.
Well, we'll hold that thought as that's the third out and we'll end the inning. Mariners are down in order. We'll go to the bottom of the second. No score. And welcome back. Bottom of the inning. Now up for Tampa Bay, Brandon Lau. The pitch. Righty delivers. And that one fouled off. Here's the 0-2. And that's down and away.
I don't think he was trying to miss by that much in an 0-2 count. Just tried to overthrow that pitch.
Laced into left. That's a base hit.
Really nice job of two-strike hitting in that at-bat. Anytime you rip a line drive the other way, you feel really good about what you did at the plate. You trusted your hands, you let the ball travel, and you took the barrel straight to it. That's great work right there.
Now, Christian Bethencourt. And that's in there for strike one. Nobody out, runner at first. Hit hard, base hit. Throw back in quickly. First and second now with nobody out.
Well, a swing like that can help you come out of this struggle. We saw the numbers coming into the ball game, but all he's trying to do at this point is help his team win.
Harold Ramirez at the dish. And a good fastball to start him off. That's strike one.
Well, the best way to shake off yesterday's struggles is to get on the board early. They've got a guy in scoring position. They've got to find a way here to get him in.
That's in there. That's strike two.
Looks like he's just sizing him up there. Really good pitch to hit, but he took it all the way. Sometimes guys just want to set their timing later on in the game. That may be a pitch that he turns on.
In the dirt, blocked.
You hear people talk about letting the ball travel so often in terms of a hitting approach, and that's a great example why right there. If he's willing to let that curveball get a little deeper into the zone before he commits, he's way more likely to recognize that it's making a beeline for the dirt. On the other side, still a nice two-strike pitch, though.
Jose Siri in the box now, takes strike one.
Really good job in this spot to get ahead in the count. He's going to have to continue, finish off this hitter.
Comes up empty on the swing, 0-2 now.
Two really good back-to-back sliders, now in an 0-2 count. He's feeling real confident about finishing this hitter off. He can go anywhere he wants.
Up and in, and the count is 1-2.
Pretty standard high 0-2 fastball right there. If you're smart, look for something down in the zone, but not too far. Don't want to chase that breaking ball in the dirt.
Fouls it off, still 1-2. Kicks and deals. In the dirt, but kept close.
Well, classic pitch sequencing there to change eye levels for the punch out. That fastball on the pitch before was off. It was very competitive, and that gets you thinking that he might try to climb the ladder. But then the curveball out of that same tunnel just falls off the table, and you can't make contact.
Vidal Brujan in the box now. Takes strike one. Now the 0-1. Popped up to the left into foul ground. And that is that. So the Rays strand a pair. We'll move to the third with no score. Welcome back. A.J. Pollock at the dish.
The designated hitter, A.J.
Springs back to work. And the first pitch misses for ball one. Pollock, a former All-Star, 35 years old. What a run over the last 10 as he's hitting over 400 during that span. So two balls and no strikes.
When you get ahead in the count, there's no doubt that the success rate goes up. And that's what he's been doing. It's made a big impact for him in recent games.
And he hits a ground ball right side, and it finds its way through for a hit. So a man on base to start the inning. Now the Mariners catcher, Harry Ford. And a foul ball. Here comes the 0-1. Runner at first with no outs here. One lifted in the air, left field, and there's one down.
Just pulled off of it a little bit right there. That front shoulder coming open instead of staying closed. If he does that, he's going to be able to go up the middle the other way with some authority instead of a fly out to left.
And up next for Seattle, Sam Pollock runs. Down the right field line and a base hit. Into third now, so runners at the corners and one out.
Well, clearly he was ready to hit right there. He really shot that one down the right field line and somehow found a way to keep it from slicing foul. One thing that was great about the approach, his head was down all the way through the pitch, and that's how you do it. Runner in scoring position now and a good opportunity to push across the first run of the ballgame.
Moore in the box, lays off for ball one. Caught looking his first time up. Got it started a little too early. Strike one. First and third, one down. Out to center, Siri in position, makes the catch, Runner tags from third. Tag. Not in time. He's safe. And it's 1-0.
Sometimes all you got to do is your job, and don't overcomplicate things. Keep it simple. Runner third, less than two outs. Put the ball in play, and a nice job with the sac fly.
Cesar Hernandez up to the plate. 0-1. Hernandez, in his 10th season, a member of the 1,000 Hit Club, and he was born in Venezuela. Haggerty, the runner at first with two gone. And 1-2.
Man, this guy's got a great feel for his breaking ball today.
Two balls, two strikes to count with two outs. Line drive. Thomas makes the grab, and that'll end the inning. A run on two hits, and they leave one. We move on to the bottom of inning number three. It's the Mariners 1, the Rays nothing. Back here at Tropicana Field, Isaac Paredes now.
The third baseman.
The right-hander back to work. Just missed. That one finds the zone. That's strike one. The wind of the pitch. Line drive, base hit. Off to a good start with a leadoff knock.
Everything came together for him. That's about as textbook as it gets. Got his stride low, out of the way early. He stayed inside that ball and squared it up out front. Man, that was like he was in the cage hitting off a tee.
And now Josh Lowe. And that's in for a strike. Left-hand batter waits. Now this is in the air down the line. And in one hops the wall. Throw comes in. Runner stops. Second and third. Nobody out.
He was all over that one. Put a pretty good jolt into that one. Great swing. Nice balance and weight transfer. And he got it to drop in out there in the deep part of the field. Now a great opportunity to at least tie up this game with something like a sac fly or an error in the infield. But another hit to the outfield could absolutely end it.
And now the right fielder, Lane Thomas. Grounded out his first time. In there for strike one. And ball one.
One ball, one strike.
That one the other way. That's a hit. In comes the run from third. We're tied at one. Runner stops at third, and they're at the corners with nobody out.
Well, we're starting over again, all tied up. Showed a willingness to drive that pitch the opposite way. Didn't get jumpy, didn't try to pull the ball. He let it get deep, took the barrel right to it, and then extended through the swing for the line drive base hit.
So runners at the corners, nobody out. Randy Arozarena next to hit for the Rays. That's in there, and that is strike one. No outs. Runners at first and third. Rolled to short. Possible two ball. Touches the bag for one, and a run scores on the double play.
Very composed play from the shortstop position right there. I mean, that was a perfect decision. Go ahead, take it yourself. Get to second, and then fire to first. Make sure you get those two outs.
Lau in the box now. No balls and a strike.
Well, I think that pitch surprised all of us. Right down the middle, doesn't get a swing. Not very often you see a hitter lay off a cookie like that.
Next offering is in for a strike. Now a screamer into the outfield. Haggerty racing over to make the catch. But two runs for him, and they jump ahead. On to inning number four. It's the Rays 2. And back now in Tampa Bay. New inning getting started. Digging in, it's the speedy outfielder, Julio Rodriguez. First offering misses badly for ball one.
Well, after putting up a nice inning on offense, got some runs across, this is where you look for the starter to go out there, have a shutdown inning. Don't give that other team any hope. You just hope that he can get through this inning, get the bats back up there while they're hot.
That one's in there, and a count one and two. And downstairs. And a pitch. Hit hard. That gets through.
Love how he let that ball travel. Up trusted his hands. Nice job of going the other way.
Christian Walker.
And now it's Christian Walker. Grounded out his first time up. In there, and it's 0-1. Runner on the go. That one ripped, and that's just foul. 0-2 now. Just missed.
Man, oh man, I don't know how you take that pitch. That's as close as it gets.
Right through there, got him. Down on strikes, and he knew it. And now Teoscar Hernandez.
Definitely wants to stay out of the double play here. Ball on the ground in the infield. Should be an inning-ending double play.
First pitch doesn't find the zone. And there's a strike.
He's gone off speed. He needs to elevate here with two strikes out of the zone.
Out towards right center field. Thomas on his way over. Flashes the leather on the running catch. That's out number two. Tyro Estrada to the plate. Rolled out to second in his first at bat.
Estrada.
Check swing went around. 0-1. Good eye right there. Rodriguez off of first with two away. Next offering is in for a strike.
It's just been an impressive outing so far. Continues to pound the zone pitch after pitch. And he's been able to stay down. That's what's been key.
Started to go after it. Now a look down to first. And that's ruled a swing. It's a strikeout. One left for Seattle. And they trail it here 2-1. Back here at the ballpark, John Giambi and Chris Singleton with you. And leading off the bottom of the fourth, Christian Bethencourt. And a pitch. And there's a ball. Hit hard, should be extra bases. Around first and hustling for second. The throw in. Not going to get him. He's in there.
Man, he just absolutely turned on that one. Ripped it down the line. Nice job of staying in the mechanics.
Harold Ramirez. Next to hit for the Rays. Struck out swinging his first time. Ball one. No strikes. 1-0. No outs, runner on second. Out into left center for a line drive base hit. Bethencourt coming home. He'll score. It's 3-1.
Two consecutive base hits for these guys here. A lot of hitters tell themselves, line drive over the infielder's head. That's what I'm trying to do. Just keep that approach simple. And right there, it was perfectly executed. On time with everything and pulled it into the gap nicely.
And now it's Jose Siri. That one's in there. That's strike one.
Well, these Rays doing a great job, Boog, of just waiting for the right pitch to come their way, and I'm seeing very patient at-bats out of them. It's not just the three runs they've already scored. On top of that, they forced this starter to throw more pitches than he wanted to at this point of the game.
The other way, and there's a base hit to right field. Lead runner to second, so two on and nobody out.
He needed that one. It's been a tough stretch at the plate lately. Nice job of driving that pitch the other way on a line. You know, hitters, they take so many reps in the cages working on going to the opposite field, and it doesn't always translate into the game, but right there it did, and he did it perfectly.
Bruján takes a ball as he stands in for the second time. No outs, runners at first and second. Hit weakly on the ground. On to first. Finally gets the first out here on the grounder.
And that pitch count is impactful because if they can keep making him work hard out there, it may force the bullpen to get involved a little sooner rather than later.
Foul back our way, and that's out of play. In the air, right field. Hernandez brings it in. Both runners tagging from second and third. Play at the plate. Not in time. He's safe. And they lead by three.
There you go. Nice little RBI there. It's a great at bat. Got the job done.
And stepping in for the Rays, Josh Lowe. That one's in there, 0-1. Siri on third with two out. That's in there, and that is strike two.
An at bat like this is almost over as it begins. In this situation, you have no idea what the next pitch is going to be. You just got to hope that you can make contact.
Cuts and misses. It's a strikeout. They get two runs on three hits, no errors, and one left. On to the top of the fifth we go. It's ready now for the fifth inning. Now it's the Mariners DH, A.J. Pollock. The big lefty turns, kicks, deals. Back up the middle and a base hit. Man aboard on the leadoff single.
Right there, he does a great job of staying in the big part of the field. Man, there are a lot of hits there.
Harry Ford up next for the Mariners. And the first offering is not close.
Well, the offense has gotten going, and a pitcher wants to go out there, have a real quick inning, get those guys back into the dugout so those bats can stay hot. Well, these Mariners need to bring up the quality of their bats and specifically their swings. They're trying to find ways to drive the ball with some authority, but it's just not happening for them so far. Zero extra base hits in the game, so it's been tough for them to get anything going. Sometimes you have to keep chipping away until you break through, but it's a lot easier to put runs on the board when you have guys in scoring position because they put themselves there.
That's a base hit. Lead runner holds up. They're at first and second with nobody out.
Now batter, left fielder, Sam Haggerty.
Next to hit, Sam Haggerty. Check swing didn't go. 1-0. The 1-0.
Two balls, no strike.
Good spot for the hitter. Definitely has the advantage in this count with runners on. Look for him to be aggressive on this next pitch.
That one down the line.
Oh.
Ground ball right side, could be two. Feeds to second, out there. On to first, double play.
For me, that's one of the toughest double plays to turn on the infield. The first baseman has to get inside, create a throwing lane to hit that middle infielder to start the double play, and then from there, completing it back to first. Really good job all the way around.
Here's Dylan Moore. Right side, hard hit. Lau sends it to first. That's the third out. Mariners leave one, and they trail it 4-1. ready to go for the last half of the inning. Now up for Tampa Bay, Lane Thomas. The pitch. And ball one to the right fielder.
Well, these Rays, digging into their numbers, have to be happy with the swings they're taking. We've heard lots of loud noise coming from their bats in this one, haven't we? I mean, they've logged six hits at 90-plus exit velocity, and that doesn't happen by accident. Couple of hits in a row for him here. Really nice job staying up the middle with his approach. He didn't try to do too much with the pitch. Just shot it through the infield.
Man at first, Randy Arozarena, next to hit for the Rays. Throw over to first, and he's back in safely. Base hit, center field. Throw back in quickly, first and second now with nobody out. Here's a new pitcher from the pen, Marco Gonzalez. He's pitching on 2 days rest. And now it's Brandon Lau. First pitch, and that's in for a strike.
Not the easiest thing when you're talking about a guy that's, you know, perhaps is going to be in the rotation, you know, maybe a long relief guy, to not start an inning, to come into an inning with pressure on it and try to get yourself comfortable.
The 0-2. Swing and a high fly ball down the right field line. Hernandez squeezes it. Both runners tagging, and the throw's offline, safe at third.
Maybe caught that one off the end just a little bit. Couldn't quite barrel it up enough to really drive it.
Christian Bethencourt, next to hit for the Rays. Strike one.
There it was. Oh, here it is. Hit it.
One strike.
He gets a take, gets ahead in the count.
Kicks and fires. There's a strike. Action in the pen down there. Justice Sheffield appears to be getting ready for manager Scott Service. Puts it in the air out towards left center. Nice grab on the run. Runner tagging from third. Throw home. He beats it. And they lead by four. And now the first baseman, Harold Ramirez.
RBI not for him last time. Now a chance to drive in another run.
First pitch just misses. There's a strike. Lined into left center, base hit. Arozarena flies around third. He will score. It's 6-1.
Now, it's just a total nightmare for lefties. I'd be very surprised to see that matchup again. And, man, I'll tell you, a line drive like that into the gap just feels so good. It's feedback that you had everything on time and in control from start to finish with your swing.
So two down. So next to the plate for Tampa Bay, Jose Siri. And that's in there for strike one. Ramirez leads off first with two down to the inning. Swing and a ball hit out towards left center field. Rodriguez snags it on the run. Two runs, three hits, no errors, and one left. We're through five. It's the Rays six and the Mariners one. We're back, and they make a change to start the sixth. The new pitcher, Garrett Clevenger.
And we all know about his slider. It's just filthy, man. And one of the better ones in the game, I'd say. Spin rate's very high, and it just breaks a ton.
And stepping in for the Mariners, Cesar Hernandez. The why to kick the pitch. Trying to bunt his way on. And it goes just foul. Clevenger, a 6'1 lefty, 220 pounds, and they went out and made a trade for him last season. That one hops against the fence, and he's going to get to second with nobody out.
Put a really nice balanced swing on it, and when you can rope one into the gap like that, you're thinking extra bases from the first couple of steps out of the box, and he'll feel real good about that one. Could be a chance here for them to start clawing back into this ballgame.
And now for Seattle, Julio Rodriguez. Now he can't squeeze it behind the plate. Tag, save. He's into third on the wild pitch.
Even with a good secondary lead, sometimes it's hard to see just how far that ball's gotten away from the catcher. And if you can make it to third base, pretty much standing up. Well, that time, he seemed to have a pretty good read, gets to third safely, and now he's just 90 feet away from scoring.
At the belt and fires. Line drive, and that should be extra bases. And that rolls into the corner. He pulls into second, and a run comes in to score. Christian Walker now at the plate. In there for strike one. Out towards left center. He's there. He's got it. Runner tags up for third. Throw, and it gets away. And he'll move up to third on the throwing error.
Now batting, the right fielder, Teoscar Hernandez.
And up next for Seattle, Teoscar Hernandez.
And this is a big opportunity for him to pick up his teammate right here.
There's a strike.
Some guys are just more confident they can track that first pitch out of the hand of the pitcher. They don't care if they fall behind 0-1.
The 0-1 is outside, and it's a ball and a strike.
If you're on the mound right now, you know you have to retire this hitter. If he gets on base, it could open up the floodgates for this offense to score some runs.
And a pitch. Stays alive. And here it comes. This appears to be a balk. And it is. Terrible timing for that sort of mistake. So that'll bring across a run.
Caught a break right there. Pretty good pitch on the outside corner.
Still only one out here in the inning. Swing and a miss. The velocity blasted it right past him.
Well, when you commit to throwing an inside fastball to your glove side across the strike zone, especially with two strikes, if you're going to miss, you want to miss off the plate in. You do not want to leave it out over the heart of the plate. So that was excellent execution on that pitch. Really tied him up, and he couldn't get a piece at all.
Way inside, gets out of the way. Pitch misses there. Three balls, no strikes. Called strike right there. Popped up. Lau puts the squeeze on that one, and that'll end the inning. So they get a couple of runs on two hits, no errors, and no one left on. 8-9-1 scheduled in the bottom of the sixth. It's the Rays. Welcome back. Bottom of the sixth. And stepping in for the Rays, Vidal Brujan. Brujan measures 5 feet 10 inches, 25 years old, usually a second baseman, but today starting at shortstop. The pitch. That's in there, and it's nothing in two.
Well, some people think this is no big deal, but I think when you consider the longer throw, the fact that you've got to be able to cover up the middle to your left, it's a big adjustment for him.
And now the lefty caught him looking for the K.
Well, he froze him with a great fastball right on the corner. It's kind of like bowling. You think the ball's going to get into the gutter, and somehow it just hangs onto that edge and knocks down a pin. Well, he got the outside corner of the plate and got that called third strike.
Swing and a ball lifted to center field. Rodriguez pulls that one down, and there are two outs.
Now batting. The left field.
Josh Lowe next to hit for the Rays. In the air, fairly deep to right field. Hernandez makes the catch, inning over. Rays held in check here, but they still lead it 6-3. Back here at Tropicana Field, now it's the DH, A.J. Pollock. That one finds the zone. Strike one. That's in there.
Quickly into an 0-2 count. Both pitches were down in the zone. I think you set your sights a little bit higher because you'll have a tendency to chase if you look down in that area.
Struck him out looking.
Well, that was a pretty poor at bat. He just never got the bat off the shoulder. I mean, you got to go up there looking to swing at some point, especially once you're down 0-2. And at that point, make an adjustment, look to put the ball in play if it's anywhere close. And I'm just not sure what the plan was there.
Ford, batting with one down, takes a strike. Oh, and two as he waves at that one. Swing and a ground ball out to short. Fires to first on the run. And a couple of quick outs.
Up next for Seattle, the left fielder, Sam Haggerty.
And stepping in for the Mariners, Sam Haggerty. First offering, and it just misses. There's a strike at the knees. Here comes a pitch. To the right side. Slings to first. Third out, and that ends the frame. Nobody left for Seattle and can't cut into that 6-3 deficit. Set for the last half of the seventh. Now the number two hitter, Lane Thomas. The wind of the pitch. Slapped foul. Next offering is in for a strike. Activity in the bullpen. Casey Sadler appears to be getting ready for manager Scott Servais. Fresh, getting cranked up as well. And a pitch. Swing and a base hit. So a runner aboard to start the inning.
Well, that certainly feels good when you can win the at-bat after being down in the count, up against it with two strikes right there. Solid swing from start to end, on time with everything, really good balance, nice extension, and he met it out front for the line drive knock.
And he deals. And a swing and a miss there.
Sometimes being lucky is a swing and miss. If he makes contact with that pitch, probably hits into a double play.
Kicks and fires. Wouldn't chase that time. Thomas aboard here at first with nobody out. On the ground, could be two. Quick feed to second for one to Walker, and that's two.
Sometimes double plays get turned so quickly that you don't really get to appreciate all of the finer details and how these guys execute them. Right there, really nice footwork, and a good feed to second was the key to pulling it off.
Lau stands in now and watches strike one. That one's in there, and it's 0-2.
Throwing the ball well, and they need this scoreless inning in relief right here. Been doing a good job keeping him in striking distance.
Swing and a pop-up. Estrada under it. He's got it, and that'll end the inning. And welcome back.
We're the top of the Mariners. The shortstop, Dylan.
Top of the eighth. Here's the Mariners' leadoff man, Dylan Moore. They turn things over to the southpaw, Colin Poche.
Not having a lot of success against right-handed hitters. They've been hitting them around, so this next matchup might be tough for them.
And there's one down.
Now that third baseman, Cesar.
And now it's switch hitting third baseman, Cesar Hernandez. First offering misses the mark. Next offering is fouled back. And Poche ready to work. Hard ground ball, base knock. He puts it in his pocket, safe at first without a play.
The batter. The center fielder.
I really like that swing, man. He didn't just push it the other way through the infield. He drove it that way, and it kind of makes me think he was thinking opposite field as he stepped into the box. Got a pitch he liked, and he got it done.
And now it's going to be Julio Rodriguez. And there's a foul ball.
Here's a run scoring opportunity. You definitely got to push something across because it's not going to get any easier. To get to the ninth, got a lockdown closer ready to come in.
The pitch. Down and in, moved his feet. Foul ball still, a 1-2 count. Just missed.
And that's awfully close. I don't know how you take that. He's seeing the ball out of the pitcher's hand really well right now.
Check swing on the 2-2. Appeal to first. And he held up. And the pitch. And that one hammered. That's back. Gone. His 16th homer of the year, and they slice into the lead. It's 6-5.
Just relentless. This team will not quit. His bat looks like it's in the zone for such a long time, and that gives him the ability to get barrel on it and hit the ball out to any part of the park.
And now it's the cleanup hitter for the Mariners, Christian Walker. That one's in there, 0-1. The tying run at the plate. Swing, and that ball smashed on a line. And it's just foul. That was close. Fights it off, you'll see another. High in the air, out to right. Thomas drifts towards it, makes the grab for the second out.
It's a good recovery, though, after giving up the home run. Not allowing it to stay in the head, but going to work at the next hitter, and a tough one at that.
Teoscar Hernandez up next for the Mariners. And the first pitch misses for ball one. Breaking ball through there for a strike. Right. And a 1-1. Swing and a foul straight back. That misses the zone, and that's ball two. Two down, nobody on. That one out to right. Thomas settles under this one. He's got it. And that is out number three. But not before they're able to draw closer with this blast. It's now 6-5. It's Major League Baseball on the show. Back now in Tampa Bay, bottom of the eighth. Here's the catcher, Christian Bethencourt. The wind of the pitch. That to right. Hernandez settles underneath it. Makes the grab, one down.
Now back. First baseman.
Now up for Tampa Bay, Harold Ramirez. First pitch, and he just misses. Some activity in the Mariners' bullpen. Casey Sadler appears to be getting loose. Next offering is in for a strike. That one drilled left field. No trouble here. Puts it away for the out. And there's two away.
Now batting, the center fielder,
Jose Siri, digs in now. In there, and it's 0-1. Swing and a line drive, slicing into right field. Can't get there. Base hit. Now he'll turn for second. In safely. It's a double and his second hit.
Back against the wall with two strikes, but found a way. Pitch was away, and he did exactly what you're supposed to do with it. Drive it the other way. Just go with the pitch.
And now it's Vidal Brujan. And that's in there for strike one. Siri stands at second with two gone. Hard grounder into the outfield for a knock. Rodriguez fires it to the plate, but it's offline. And they lead by two.
Puts a run on the board and picks up an RBI. Everyone's trying to elevate the ball in today's game, but if you can hit a ball that hard on the ground, it's going to find some holes.
Runner at first with two away. Isaac Paredes next to hit for the Rays. That's hard hit on the line. Makes the grab, and that's the inning. But the RBI single pushes across a run. Last chance coming up for the Mariners. And the Rays, they go to the bullpen. Camilo Doval.
And if you dig into his walk rate, his numbers are really impressive. He's really filled up the strike zone this season, so these guys better be ready to swing the bats.
And now for Seattle, Tyro Estrada. The pitch. And first offering is fouled off. Doval, a 6-2 righty. He features a slider, a cutter, and he works in a sinker. Estrada started after it, tried to hold up. Now look to first, and yes, he offered at it. In now is the Mariners' DH, A.J. Pollock. In there for strike one. Strike on the inside corner.
0-2 Cal, both pitches on the inside part of the plate. Hitter is thinking, I don't want to get beat here. This is a good time for something off speed away.
Siri makes the grab, and there's two gone. And up next for Seattle, Harry Ford. It's interesting, he plays kind of a power spot defensively, but runs pretty well. So when you're looking at that position, you're not expecting someone that has maybe above average speed, but he does. Swung on, popped up on the infield. Lau in position, and he'll make the catch. Ball game. And the Rays take the finale and earn a split of this four-game series.
Well, these guys secure a winning season with the W today. And regardless of what else happens the rest of the way, you know that you're a winning ball club. So a little bit of pressure off, put your foot on the gas, and just see where you can finish from this point on.
Victorious Rays, 7 runs on 14 hits, no errors.